One of the main causes of failures in an audio amplifier is hum. And in this video I want to pay some attention to the issue of hum. Hum can be caused by all kinds of reasons. The transformer has a stray field that strays a certain frequency, 50 Hz or 60 Hz, into the location where the amplifier is. The power supply here can also be a cause of hum. When the AC is not properly rectified, you will have you will hear the hum through the loudspeakers from your amplifier. Another cause of hum is caused by the non-proper shielding from the enclosure. And then I mean that the enclosure is not connected to the ground. And then I mean the ground from the grid here. So this is a small demo. Here you hear the hum from the loudspeaker. It goes somewhat. Hope you hear it, and the bandwidth from the YouTube channel is not so small that you don't hear it. And this cabinet is not connected to the ground from the grid. So I have made here a crocodile clip. Now I'm going to connect the ground grid here to the metal enclosure. And you will hear that this diminishes the hum somewhat. But you can also hear that an other hum takes place instead of the first hum. And this hum is caused by the shielding, the not proper shielding from all the amplifiers inside your audio amplifier. So in this case the preamplifier. This has to do for a big deal with the impedance from the input here from the preamplifier. I don't know what the impedance from this amplifier is. Here we see a wire goes to a coupling capacitor and then to the base from the first transistor. That means that this wire hangs in fact in the air and can act as an antenna that picks up hum from this transformer. So when I switch the transformer off, you can hear that the hum disappears. So we have to shield this wiring from the influences from the transformer. You can see already that the transformer is shielded by itself by a piece of metal here, completely enclosed in a very thick piece of sheet metal. But in fact for these low frequencies this does not work very properly. That's my experience for many years. It does not make sense, not make much sense to shield such a big transformer with such a big current. That's also an issue. When the transformer has a very low current, it's possible to shield it properly. Okay, takes too much time to discuss that issue. But we go back to the preamplifier. Put on the amplifier again. We hear the hum again. And a very easy way to test whether your amplifier, whether your preamplifier is shielded properly, is to use your hand as a shielding. When you listen to the loudspeaker, I hope you can listen, you can hear it now. I move my hand and it's not so very clear. But it's one way to test whether shielding from wiring is necessary. Of course, we all know the braided tubes that can be used. It's slided over the wiring and then connected to, on one location, to the metal cabinet. That's one way of shielding cables that are free flowing and pick up hum from the transformer. They can also pick up all kinds of other signals, let's say from the vacuum cleaner or the washing machine. All these free these wirings that hang freely are in fact antennas. So something to take care about. You can also lower the impedance by connecting a resistor from the input to ground. Of course, you have to be aware of the fact that the impedance here has a fixed value depending on the apparatus that you connect. So in this case, the CD player, DVD player was connected. It has at its output a certain impedance, and in fact you don't know whether it delivers its signal via a capacitor or not. So this can also cause problems when you connect here directly a resistor, low value resistor, 1K, 2K to ground. But sometimes it can work. And when you build your amplifier yourself, you have everything under control. You can make the circuit just like you want and just like you need. So this was one issue, shielding here, lower impedance, shielding this part of the cable. And another very drastic measure is to shield the whole circuit. I want to demonstrate it now. Put out the amplifier. Take the plug out. That's another way of shielding. It's a very easy way. You take a Coca-Cola can with a pair of scissors. You take out the tin plate and you put the whole tin plating over as a sort of tube. You cover your amplifier with it. Of course, don't make shortcuts. Very easy to make shortcuts in this case. Sometimes I isolate the inner side from the sheet metal with a piece of paper or so, or very thin piece of plastic to avoid shortcuts. But this can help a lot to avoid this typical type of hum that you have heard now out of the loudspeakers. And this type of hum especially occurs with preamplifiers. They are very sensitive at their input. So the sensitive input takes up the signal from the transformer and other signals. And end amplifiers like this are, generally spoken, not so very sensitive to hum, except from IC amplifiers. And tube amplifiers are also very vulnerable. So also here you can do the same tricks. I wish you luck.